Good morning and good morgen for Paas and Furis and welcome back to my new video. My name is Skyfire Telspin and in today's video we are going to take a closer look about modeling something here. So in generally being developer. So yeah, since I just woke up, I decided let's start with making this kind of video tutorial for you. So yeah. And after I've been fully woken up, I start making and working my yesterday sketching what I started. Yeah. So in today's video we are gonna play with cubes a lot. Unshading, basically. Yeah. So you all probably know that, or maybe you also may have some kind of wall self. So yeah. So let's start making this cube as a single plane. So we are gonna basically scale it down, like, let's say that way. Yeah. And now let's make like this way. Yeah. So this will be our first plane for that one. Yeah. We can actually make, if we like, we can basically make another kind of self actually. So yeah. So I'm basically going to take this one, modify the scaling, pasting it here, down here, and still one here, like that way. Yeah. Now let's shrink it that way, and let's quickly add new plane. Actually, not plane, but let's actually include a cube, because as I said, we are gonna basically play with the cubes. So move this cube behind here, scale it like that way, reposition it over here, like this way, yeah. And shrink it down, matching it all of these sides, pretty much like, no, still a little bit. Like this way, yeah. And start playing with this position, basically. Yeah. So we are pretty much on done. Yeah. One tip is that what I actually already say to do is select all of these points over here and just move them like this way. Yeah. Just a little bit more, not too much. And like that way. Yeah. Now, let's go here. Let's take that. And let's scale this boy up. Like that way. Yeah. So this gives us basically a really nice self. Yeah. So I'm gonna basically move that here. And now let's add one more cube. So this time scale it like this way. So this will be the side walls for this self. Yeah. So I usually like to move it here, like that way, matching the height and dimension and everything sizes. So yeah. So as being a developer, you had to learn all of the basics. So yeah. And keep in mind that what you like to do. Yeah. Do you really like to do something like this one? Yeah, probably. but you didn't have nice software or any software where you can do it. Yeah, well, Blender is for your choice then. Yeah, I'm already say as a developer of my own virtual reality chat room. The Blender is pretty much the tool what you need to have when you are starting something. Yeah. Duplicate this and move it over here. Like that way. And you're supposed to have something like this one. Yeah. So yeah. So I'm gonna basically move this a little bit here. And matching all of these sizes pretty much. Yeah. And keep in mind, it doesn't have and doesn't need to be the perfect one at the starting point. So this is more like a simple tutorial for you. So yeah. So let's say that you haven't never done anything like that. You can actually follow this video and follow this guide pretty much and try make your very own props and furnitures into your games or in your game world, yeah, basically, so game map. And now that we are basically done, let's quickly merge all of this together, so Control and C. So yeah, let me type it over here. So over here, which I highlighted over my top right corner, press that to merge all of these into one layer. So into one shape, basically. But don't do that yet. Because we haven't done any shading, so we don't have any textures in this object. And we are gonna basically make all of these textures quickly. So yeah. And as usually, just play with this system. I like to make something like this one. Maybe it's a little bit brighter. Yeah, that's gonna be it. Now I'm basically copying this options, going here, actually, so yeah, so you had to basically make a new one, remove that, and paste your new desired output over here, so you can easily select these colorings, and now let's do that same thing for rest of things. Yeah, this time I'm gonna basically make it selectively darker and copying that one, making new, removing that, placing my own desired thing. Yeah. Like this way. And now you have your very own furniture, what you can use. Are you very proud of yourself? Good job, pals, good job. You made it very first furniture into your works. Yeah. And this is basically the basics of making something in Blender. In the fastest and the easiest way. Yeah. So, now it's time to start playing with the render tab. Let's add quickly one point like it. So, as a developer, you probably like to test out the shadowing and the lighting and the light systems like this way. Yeah. Alright, that seems very nice. I like it. Maybe a little bit more of the volume and the power. and probably a little bit different color. Yeah, that seems fine. So I will copy that, paste one over here. So yeah, just like this way. And now we have something like that one. Now what we can do is basically selecting all of these cubes and marking all of them in one specified layer. So yeah. And now we have this one. Now you can easily to basically move this around, rotate this entire thing basically, yeah. And that is pretty much how you can start making your own assets in Blender, pretty much. But as a developer, you have to keep in mind that the more time you spend by modeling something, the more better it will be. So yeah, so you can probably see that I didn't spend too much doing this. There is even one issue. So yeah, as a developer, you had to basically manually fix those things. Yeah. So I'm basically taking that, checking over here. Okay, I see that there is gaps. And I will not say if I work in a company. And I just take a screenshot. Dear company and director, I just finished your wanted asset. How it looks like. Director is reviving it in the Blender. And then director comes here. Oh, yeah. That's bad. That side is good. Director. Hey. And dear and developer. I revived and checked your asset. Both in pictures and both also in Blender. I noticed that there is gaps and some issues. Please refine and revise your model by making sure there won't be any gaps. Okay, as a developer, I will come back to Blender and check what he talked about. Okay, that side is good. Oh, now I see and now I get why the director wanted me to rework this model. Yeah. Thank you, director. I will make sure it will be much better in next time. Yeah. So, as a developer, I will start fixing it like this way. Yeah. And please note this, I'm not working in companies, I'm not working for anyone. So it was basically acting that how it would look like if I called working companies that there is a director who is reviving my assets in personally in the Blender. Yeah. Okay, the director didn't mention this one, so yeah, let me see what I can do for that one. Yeah, I select that. But I had to be clever. Okay, I'm gonna basically select that, and select that. Point. Alright, let's do it really carefully. Okay, now maybe I can actually exceed that a little bit, so I will take this and duplicate that one. And just manually try to fix that one. Yeah. But also notice that usually the developers work full in different way their assets than I do. But at least, well, you can get something fun out of this content. Yeah. Oh, yeah, let me fix that one. Oops, that was the wrong one. Yeah, now it's supposed to be a much better. Yeah, and now as a developer, I will connect once more everything. And hello, director. I reworked the model and the asset what you wanted to be updated. Then director comes here. Okay, maybe that backside of this asset can be actually go inside of the wall, so it's not so big a deal after all. Generally, okay. Is there any gaps? I'm the best gap hunter. Oh, seems like he forget that one. And the same thing goes up. And here is updated version. Please revive and execute. Yeah. So the director came in. All right. No more gaps. See, well, at least seems like so. Yeah. Now it's much better and basically finished. Yeah. Well, I want only one thing on this model. And it's a black outlines. Seriously? Black outlines for this asset? How I can do that one? But then director will say, hey, it was just an inside joke. No black linings for our assets whatsoever. We don't like to make that asset look like anime asset. Yeah. Oh, luckily it wasn't just inside joke, yeah. Those are the best one. So this is basically the life of a developer. Yeah. Acted very best as I can. Yeah. But since I made this, I can give this copy. For the director and for the game engineers, and they can actually include this one. But as personally, I can keep one copy as myself. And well, if he wanted that black outlines, but it was, well, sadly it was a inside joke. Well. I want to see how it would look like with the black outlinings. How I can even do that one? So the black outlines like anime style. Okay. Yeah. So I can basically make that by myself and see that later on how its world actually look like as with the black outlines basically. But honestly, this is much better. Yeah. But I'm not very sure how it would look like if their color be black outlines. So yeah. But now that I have this one, I can start making tons and tons of shelves. Like over here. This way. So we can start making even more of these ones. So yeah. So we can even place all of these in the top of Exoter and see if that actually works in some way. Maybe that doesn't work. Okay. How about if I just move them here? Yeah. Oh, no, it's more like In marketplace. Well, we need one more things for that one. Yeah. So game and engineer or whoever works with their the assets and see them in the game war. They may try in different ways, like something like this way. Okay. Well, we need to make some kind of market into this game war. But we need to use these assets. Yeah, let's move it a little bit here. Yeah. And now we have something like this one. But anyways, this was a life of developer as nutshell. Yeah. But please note this. I'm not still working for companies, I'm not working for anyone. I just work all of this by fun and by my own. Yeah. But indeed, I'm a developer by myself. In that meaning that I'm actually developing my own studio and my office into the Verksat. So yeah. So I can play with this shape like this way. Ooh, that looks really interesting. Yeah. So now I have only one thing to do. And it's a giving name. Shelf. Stealth. Type. And saving it. Shelf 4. Yeah. And that is how you can easily to model something. No, I mean modeling but the background assets and not the characters. I'm not gonna do any character modeling because they actually takes a lot more time and a lot more effort basically. Since it needs basically sculpting and modeling. It actually needs both of that ones. And then vector painting, vector rigging, vector boning, painting, texturing, shadings. So it has even a lot of more work than this one. So yeah. But I go get more coffee and I start uploading and editing. I mean editing and uploading this video. And then I'm heating to sketching out a wolf. At least working my yesterday wolf sketching. So yeah. But hey, see you next time, Furballs. Bye bye. Have above some day.